Okay, the next topic is cost of capital. It's there in your page number 34. Page number 34, cost of capital. Okay, can we start? Name itself is saying, sir, cost of capital. So what does that mean? Here capital does not mean, don't apply accounting concept. Capital in accounts means share capital, preference share capital and all. Here capital means source of finance. All the source of finance will be considered as a capital, meaning equity share capital also is a capital, preference share capital is also, bank loan is also a capital. Okay, so we are trying to find out, or what is the emphasis there? Cost of capital. So what does that mean? Cost incurred to raise the money, a source of finance. If you take a bank loan, let's say 10% is the bank loan. So what is the cost of capital? 10%. So if you take a bank loan, bank will expect an interest rate of 10%. So yes or no? So that's what we are trying to find out here. Finding out the cost of capital for each source of finance. Clerically, they'll not give us. We need to find it out. Work it out. Work out the cost of capital for various sources of finance. Okay. So do we need to find out, what is the objective of finding cost of capital? Why do we need to find that? What is the objective? Why do we need to find cost of capital? There only, or else first objective is given there only. What is the first objective given? Significance of cost of capital or importance is for investment. So what does that mean? Or let's say you want to do a particular project and that project will give you a return of, let's say, 12%. If you undertake that project, it will give you a return of how much? 12%. But cost of raising the money is 15%. Cost of capital is how much? 15%. Will you take that investment now? Because benefit you're getting is only 12% in the form of return. I'm taking long run. Throughout, you get a benefit of 12%. But throughout, your cost of capital is 15%. So will you take that? That means it will help you with your investment options, whether to go ahead with the investment or not. That can be sorted with the help of cost of capital. Simple, yes or no? It will help you sort out investment decisions. What is the second one? Financing decisions. You can go either for bank loan. Let's say you are looking at source of finance. You can go for a bank loan. Let's say bank charges 12%. Or you can go for debentures by giving 10% interest rate. You can either raise the money by going for a bank loan which charges 12% or debentures with 10%. Which one will you go for? Debentures. Yes or no? Meaning cost of capital will help you to compare various sources of finance. Just one comparison, you can't draw a line, because also you should consider, remember the source of finance, three factors: cost, risk as well as control. Alright, all these three factors also should be considered. But if risk and return, or rather risk and control, is same, then you will choose that source of finance which has the lowest or highest cost of capital. Which has the lowest cost of capital. So that means it'll help you to sort out one more decision, which is what? Financing decision. One, it'll help you with investment decision. Two, it helps you with finance decision. Easy so far? Third one is what? Optimum credit policy. This cost of capital will help you determine how much credit you want to give it to debtors. Let's say you want to give, you're thinking you will give 90 days credit to your debtors. Are we okay? If you're giving 90 days credit to the debtor, mean when will you recover the money? Now or later? Later. That means you have lost something, which is opportunity cost is lost. Can I say it this way? Had you got the money now, you could have made an investment for that 90 days and earned some money. Correct or no? Let's say the opportunity cost is 10%. Are we okay? Everybody, we'll compare that cost benefit of analysis. Basically, whether I'll benefit by giving the credit or by recovering the money right now. By giving the credit, what will happen? He will buy more, meaning your sales will be more, meaning your profit will be more. All right, but by the same time, giving credit, you'll lose out on opportunity cost. You'll compare the two. Whichever is beneficial, you'll check. So it'll help you in determining an optimal credit policy as well. Does that make sense? Or once more? Okay, so far three factors we covered. Cost of capital will have one, help with investment decisions, whether to go ahead with that investment or not. Two, it help with financial decision, or which source of finance should we go for. By doing, we'll obviously go for that source of finance which, where the cost of capital is the lowest. Third one, it'll help you to determine the optimum credit policy that we give it off to the debtors. Good enough so far? All right, one more. We'll know this and then we'll go for the problem. Determination of cost of capital. Here, cost of capital does not mean what is given to the banker. Or let's take a simple example. Okay, maybe I'll tell this word and then we'll look at the example. Cost of capital does not mean the actual amount that you're paying. It implies the expectation. Cost of capital means not the actual amount you're paying, but the expectation of the providers of finance. Let me elaborate that a little bit. Let's say you want to give a debentures. Debenture holders are expecting 15% interest. Their expectation is 15%. Is it okay? You told I can give only 13%. You can go maximum up to the extent of 13, but their expectation is 15. What will they say? One, they will say, give debentures at a discount. Possible. I want 15%, but you're giving me only 13%. So I will not subscribe the debenture at face value. I will subscribe it at a discount. Is it okay? 100 worth of debentures. Let's say they buy it at 97. At 3 rupees, they're buying less. That is a return for them. Yes or no? Or they will say what? Repay the debentures at a premium. Don't give me 100 back. Give me 110. Is this okay? So now tell me, is the cost of debenture really 13%? You are giving them 13%, but is it really 13%? One, they subscribe the debentures at a discount. Two, you are paying the debenture holders at par or premium? Premium. That means you are paying more. That means is the cost of capital 13 or a lot more? Lot more. Hence, the cost of capital does not signify what is being paid, but it signifies the expectation. Is the meaning clear? Because what is paid may not be the actual cost. We would have paid, there could be some cover-ups. Got it, sir? Everybody? Yes, yes or no, sir? Yes, sir. Some energy, sir, at least in the last moments. Okay, next, we'll try to find out the cost of long-term debt. We'll go for the features a little later. We'll work out as to how to find out the cost of a long-term debt. So long-term debts from the calculation perspective can be categorized into two things, redeemable debts and irredeemable debts. Redeemable means what? They have a specific maturity period, meaning you have to repay them. Let's say redeemable after 10 years means what? You have to pay them back after 10 years. If it is irredeemable debentures means? Go on paying the interest, no need to repay the principal back. Yes, that's what irredeemable debentures mean. Correct, no guys? So we have to compute cost of debentures for two things. One is redeemable debentures or irredeemable debts. Can we go ahead with irredeemable debentures first or irredeemable debt first? Simple formula is given. Are you able to see that formula that I'm projecting? KD as in, not the Kannada KD. It should be K below that D. Okay, but it's been typed as like that, KD. Okay, so KD as in cost of debentures. How do you get the KD? They're laughing. They're looking at me and saying KD. I don't know why. Probably I look like that to them. Anyways, so formula. What is the formula? I as in interest multiplied by 1 minus T. T as in tax rate divided by NP. NP as in net proceeds. Fancy formula. Let's try to simplify. You want to invest 1 lakh in fixed deposit. Banks give you 10% in return. Can you tell me how much is the interest amount? Can you tell me the interest amount, guys? How did you get that? 1 lakh into 10%, which is how much? 10,000. Yes or no? What is this 1 lakh, by the way? Principal amount. So can I say interest is equal to principal into rate? If I give you principal, can you find out the rate for me? How do you find out the rate? Rate is equal to interest divided by principal. Yes or no? That is what we have done here also. I as in interest. NP as in net proceeds. That is nothing but the principal amount of money you received when you issued debentures. Are we okay? Everybody? But one thing we didn't get, which is what? 1 minus tax rate. What is that 1 minus tax rate? We have done this in AS 20 EPS if you remember. Diluted EPS to be very specific. Even if you don't remember that, still you can answer me. What is that 1 minus tax rate? Interest is a charge against profit or appropriation of profit. Charge, meaning it is compulsory. Yes or no? Or in simple words, interest is an expense or an income? Expense. What does expense do to your profit? Because of interest, profit will be reduced. If profit is less, means tax will be more or tax also will be less? Tax also will be less. Yes or no? That means because of interest, you can save the tax? Yes or no? That means if they say, let's say cost of the debenture is 10% and tax rate is 30%. That means what? Though you are paying 10% interest to the debenture holders, you can save 30% in the form of tax, because tax is an expense. Interest is an expense. Expense will reduce the profit. Hence, it will also reduce tax. Yes or no? So how much savings can you save in form of tax? 30%. That means is your cost effectively 10% or only 7%? How did you get that? 10% into 1 minus tax rate. Yes or no? That is what we are writing in the formulas. Easy. Once more. If all the logic is go in the mean, just remember the formula as it is. Interest into 1 minus tax rate divided by the net proceeds. Net proceeds means the amount that you have received when you issued the debentures. If they have not given that, you can take current market price. Is that okay? For old debentures, we take current market price. For new debentures, we take the what? The like an amount that you received when you issue the debentures, or maybe that we'll take it up when we do the problems. Are you okay with this formula, guys? If you know the formula, we can apply it in question number one. Yes or no? Everybody unanimous? Need a minute or okay? Need a minute or okay, sir? Okay, can we go through the first question then? Can we do the first?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Alright, first question. 5 years ago, stop there only. 5 years ago, or maybe one line, few lines we'll read. Sona Limited issued 12% irredeemable debentures at 103. Are you giving the debentures right now, or is it old debentures? That means, will we use the net proceeds, or will we use the net proceeds when we receive the debentures, or will we use the current market price? For old debentures, the emphasis is more given on the current market price. For the fresh issue of debentures, the emphasis is on the money received that you when you issued the debentures right now. So here, what is the emphasis? Current market price. If that is not given, you'll use net proceeds. That is 103. We'll see the data accordingly. Did you get that pointer, everybody? You'll have to remember this. So, okay. 5 years ago, at what price did you roll out the debentures? 103. At 3 rupees premium at par value of 100. 100 was the face value of debentures, but you rolled out at 103. But for the time being, net proceeds looks at 103. Have they given the current market price? Current market price of the debenture is 94. So the question to you is, will you use 94 or 103 for your calculation? Since it's old debentures, the emphasis is given on the current market price, which is 94. So 94 will be your NP. First observation. Okay. Unanimous. Next. If corporate rate of tax is about 35%, calculate the current cost of debenture capital. Can you help me with the formula? What is the formula? Question number one. KD, cost of debentures is nothing but interest into 1 minus tax rate divided by net proceeds. Net proceeds could mean the amount received when you issue the debentures or current market price. Here we'll be using the current market price. So KD, what percent debentures are these? 12%. Interest dividend is always calculated on the face value. How much is the face value? 100. So that means, can you tell me interest per debenture? Or maybe we'll work out the base data first initially. I as in interest. Interest is equal to what? On one debenture, it will be 100 into 12%. Can I write 12 rupees, guys? Everyone? Tax rate is given to me. Tax rate is 35%. NP in this case will not be 103, but it will be current market price of 94. So that means all the data we have. Yes, yes or no? So cost of the debentures will be what now? It will be 12 into 1 minus tax rate. 1 minus tax rate, can I say 0.35? 35% is 0.35, yes or no? Divided by 94, which will be how much? KD is equal to how much? Calculate. Calculation is part is yours. Huh? 0. You get in 0, no? 0.08297. Or we can, if you convert it into percentage, it will be 8.29% or 8.30%. So what does that mean? What does that mean, guys? though you are paying 12% interest rate, but the cost of raising this capital is only 8.29%, because you can save something in the form of tax, and current market price has reduced. That's the emphasis. Is it okay? So this will be used for our decision making function and not the 12% that we are actually paying. Got it? Okay. Hope you're able to follow. Two more problems is the target for today. Then we all leave happily ever after. Can we? Anyone to copy? Can we go for the second question? Okay. All right. Okay, I think second one is a redeemable debentures. For redeemable debentures, earlier was one for a irredeemable debentures. If it is a redeemable debentures, the formula is slightly different. Big formula. Are you able to see it on the board? I into 1 minus tax rate. I think that we are able to digest. Yes or no? In plus what? RV. RV as in redemption value. NP as in net proceeds. We know this. In case of old debentures, net proceeds in case of new debentures, current market price in case of old debentures. Yes or no? Correct? No, guys? No? Correct? No? First problem, Sona, no? What is? Yeah, Sona Limited gave new debentures, or it was 5 years ago? 5 years ago. So did we use 103 or 94? 103 was the money that you raised by giving debentures, but we took 94. Why did we take 94? Because it was a current market price and it was in case of a old debentures. That's what here also they've written. Not a spelling mistake, no? Correct? No? Not an error. Correct only it is. Alright. So divided by N. N is for remaining life of debentures. Whole thing divided by RV plus NV divided by 2. Basically, in case of redeemable debentures means what? You have to pay back the money. Correct or no? So now check here. You took 100 rupees. When you gave debentures, the debenture holders gave how much to the company? 100. Let's say you are repaying 105 to them. How much did you took? Company took 100. How much are they repaying in form of debentures? 105. Are they paying same or are they paying extra? Extra. How much extra is that? 5. That is what is this. Because that 5 is also a return for the debenture holders. Yes or no? Correct or no? If it's a return for the debenture holders, it'll be a cost for the company, and we are working it out from the company side. Hence, for redeemable debentures, you need to also consider that. Redemption value minus the net proceeds divided by the number of life of the life remaining. Whole thing here is, since you have two factors to play with, they take the average cost. How do you find the RV and NP average cost? RV plus NP divided by 2. Is that okay? That way formula slightly get reversed off here. I'll just give you a minute. Observe the formula. Try to remember it. Simple one. Interest into 1 minus tax rate. Is that the only return, or you also give extra? You give extra. What is that extra you give? That is nothing but RV. RV as in redemption value minus NP divided by the life of the remaining debentures. Because over the remaining life only you'll have to give that extra return. No? So divided by N. This divided by the average cost of the debentures. How do you get average cost? RV plus NP divided by 2. This is in case of redeemable debentures. Yes. Try to mentally register that. FM is one-way scoring because it's all a formula game. Majority are formula driven. Gordon formula, this formula, 101 formulas is there. So if you are able to remember the formulas, complications, they can make it really lesser. Straight away you'll be able to score full marks there. There is a disadvantage loophole also. If you forget the formula, 0. Okay, that's the reason we are trying to do as many problems, bring in as many charts as possible, so that you are able to register them and revise them on the examination day. But easy to score. And accompanied by this is an economics. Again, a theory driven topic. So that means for group 2 wise, FM and ECO as a good scoring subject. You can easily try to score an exemption here. Very much a possibility, because 10 marks is just theory. Other 50 marks is driven by practicals, and practicals are all driven by formulas like this. So it is just a case of a little practice. Hence, we are also not doing some 8 to 10 questions. We have kept number of questions to be as lengthy as possible, so yeah, you'll be able to revise it in the class itself. Yeah. Can we go for the second question, guys? All right. a company issued 10,000 10% debentures of 100 each. What is 10%? The actual interest. Is that the cost of debentures? Very well learned now that cost of debentures will be very much different from the actual interest that you are paying, because cost of debentures signifies the expectation. 10% here signifies the actual payment. Got it? No? Okay, so 100 is the face value, 10% is the interest rate. Can you tell me on one debenture how much would be the interest? Face value of debenture is 100, interest rate is 10%. On one debenture, what will be the interest? 100 into 10%, which is 10 rupees. Yes or no? On 10,000, it will be something, but we'll work with one debenture. Easy to, number will be smaller. However, did you get this debentures at par or premium? Premium. Premium of what percentage? 10%. That means you rolled out at 110 rupees. 100 plus 10%, which is 110. And when did you give? 1st April 2017. To be matured on 1st April 2022. Between 1st April 17 to 1st March 22, how many years are there? 17, 18. Correct, no? 18, 19, 19, 20, 20, 21, 21, 22. That means how many years? So means what is the maturity period of debentures indirectly they say? These debentures are given for a term of 5 years. Do we require this 5 years? Because it is a case of a redeemable or irredeemable debentures. If it's redeemable debentures, you have to divide something by N. N was what? Life remaining. What is the life remaining here? 5 years. Yes or no, sir? Correct? Okay. The debentures will be redeemed on maturity. Compute the cost of debentures assuming 35% tax rate. So formula will be, what are the components of formula we require? Interest. Do we know interest? Which is how much? Interest will be 100 into 10%, which is 10 rupees. Correct? No. 1 minus tax rate. Have they given tax rate? Yes. That's all. Is the return or something else is also there? Premium. Are you? No. Check. These debentures are issued at premium. That means what? You received how much money? On one debentures you received 110. Did they say it's also redeemed at premium? If nothing is given about redemption, what do you assume? It is redeemed at par. That means you are redeeming it at 100. That means it's a case of what? Are you giving any extra return? So what is the formula, by the way? I into 1 minus tax rate plus RV minus NP divided by N. What is RV? Redemption value, which is how much? 100 minus NP. It's a new debenture or old debentures? New or old? The company issued, they're saying. That means it is a now activity. That means you'll take what? Current market price or the issue price? How much is that? 110. So RV is 100. Issue price is 100 or NP is 110 divided by 5. Is this okay? Alright. Whole thing divided by RV plus NP divided by 2. Can we apply the formula first? Which question was that? Anyways, question number 2, right? We'll write the formula for our remembrance sake. Question 2. Formula will be cost of debt. KD is equal to I into 1 minus tax rate plus RV redemption value minus net proceeds divided by N. Then average cost RV plus NP whole thing divided by 2. We'll keep the data ready. I as in interest. So face value of one debenture was 100. Actual interest you're paying is how much percentage? 10%. That means I is 10 rupees. Correct? No. Tax rate is 35% or 0.35. Can we write? Next, we require RV. RV as in redemption value. How much are we redeeming? 100, because they didn't say anything about that. NP here, however, will be 100 plus 10% premium, which will be 110. And N, maturity period or life remaining, is about 5 years. So we have all the data ready. Can we compute? So KD will be what? Interest, that is 10 into 1 minus tax rate, which will be 0.35, plus RV 100 minus NP 110 divided by life remaining, which is 5. Whole thing divided by 100 plus 110 divided by 2. Calculation is yours, guys. Just have to give me the cost of debt. Or if you want, you can give me these numbers. So this is 6.5 plus that you can give me. Minus, notice. Minus 2. Yeah. This one 210, so it is what, 105 divided by 105. So how much it will be? So 4.5 divided by 105, which is nothing but 0.0428 or 4.28%. So though effectively you're giving 10%, but the cost of capital of debt is only 4.28%. Can we get to the last question of the day? Our last question, can you do? It's the same any which way for practice. I'll help you maybe with the reading of the question. All of you have done with copying, or anyone yet to copy? None. Okay, question number 3. A company issued about 10% debentures of 100 each. 100 is your face value. So can you tell me what will be the interest on one debenture? 10. At par. That means we are giving it at 100 itself. That means net proceeds is 100, because we are issuing it at par. Par value is 100 per debenture. One debenture data will take and work out. Not necessary all the debentures you need to work out. To be matured on 1st April 22. It's the same date. That means what is the maturity term? Or rather, hang on. We gave it on 1st April 2012. Okay, and to be matured on 1st April 22. That means how many years was the originally matured term? 10 years. The company wants to know the cost of its existing debt as on 1st April 2017. Stop there. 1st April 2017 means, did you roll out or give the debentures on 1st April 2017 or you have already given? That means, is it old debentures or new debentures? Existing debt or new debt? Existing debt or new debt? Existing debt, we use what? Net proceeds or we use current market price? Current market price. Yes or no? First observation. Are you able to understand that? Once more. Understood? Once more. Once more. When did you give the debentures? 1st April 2012. What is the maturity? 2022. And when you have to find out the cost of debentures? 1st April 2017. As on 1st April 2017, did you already give the debentures or you're giving it now? You gave the debentures on 1st April 2012 itself. That means how many years over? 5 years are already over. So existing old debentures or new debentures it is? Old debentures. For old debentures, we prioritize what? Current market price. That was all I was trying to say. Is it okay? When the current market price of the debenture is 980 rupees. So what data you will take? NP, you will take it as 100 or 80? Here you will take it as 80. Correct? Compute the cost of debentures, assuming tax rate is 35%. All the data is there with you now. All the data is with you. Can you work it out and tell me the cost of debt? Hope you have understood. Any doubt, please sort out. It was a very, very simple problems. Life, N is for, in the formula, just check, what was N? N is for the remaining life of debentures. When are you trying to find out the cost of debt? 1st April 2017. As on 1st April 17, you have 10 years life remaining or only 5 years? 5 years, you will take that. N is nothing but not the total life, it is the remaining life. So N here will be 5 years. I have to put it up or you will do? You do it? How much is your getting? Unfortunately, answer doesn't seem to match out, sir. Check, working here. Maybe you are wrong or study material is wrong. One of them is wrong. Don't know which one. In 5 years. 11.67%. You took N as 5 only, no? Yeah. So then calculation error, sir. Check the plus minus is enough. It should be 11.67%. No, what, sir? Common mistake all of you did, huh? What is that? Huh? 6 plus 4. Okay. So again, just to emphasize, the cost of debt ka formula is I into 1 minus tax rate plus RV minus NP divided by N. N as in remaining life divided by RV plus NP divided by 2. So I'll just put it up just in case if you're wondering. Interest here will be 10. No? 1 minus tax rate is 0.35 plus RV was what? Redemption value is 100 minus net proceed was 80 because we don't take the issue. We took the current market price divided by life remaining, which is 5 years. Whole thing divided by 100 plus 80 divided by 2. So which will give you overall answer to be, I'll not write everything. Overall answer is 0.1166 or 11.66 percentage. All right, that moment we are eagerly waiting for. Done. See you.